Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another quick pick prediction video. In this video, I'll be predicting the women's strawweight bout between Weili Zhang versus Rose Namajunas. So you got the current strawweight champion, women's strawweight champion, and Weili Zhang versus the former women's strawweight champion and Rose Namajunas, or at least a former strawweight champion. There has been, what, like three or four now? Yeah, three or four, something like that. Maybe five, but either way. This fight, how I see this one right here is this could be this is a quick pick, so I don't have to really talk that much about it. But how I see this one, I'm gonna be honest, I think Rose Namajunas is the more technical fighter. I think that's what it said on paper, and that's what it's being promoted as. She is the more technical fighter overall. I definitely think in grappling, boxing, overall striking, I don't think the gap is that big or at all technically. But boxing, I give her clean bit and a decent to significant amount of skill in the boxing range, the boxing area over or boxing realm over Weili Zhang. A little better footwork, but yeah, like little things better here. Submission grappling, a good significant advantage there. But even if you could have a significant advantage, you gotta factor in strength, size, and style. And even if you could have that advantage, people can neutralize that advantage. And I think Weili Zhang can neutralize any advantage that Namajunas has. And I actually think Weili Zhang could push a higher pace longer than Namajunas. I think Weili Zhang's tougher than Namajunas, definitely hits harder than Namajunas, and at times is faster than Namajunas. Matter of fact, I'm gonna say she is faster than Namajunas. She's faster than Namajunas. Faster, more explosive, stronger, more durable, and can push a higher pace for longer. I feel like Namajunas starts to, her pace starts to drop as the fight goes on, especially like from third on. I don't see her as a fighter that can truly maintain the pace unless it's like one-way traffic. You know, some fighters, they could be in the most competitive fight, but they can maintain that pace from start to finish. Some fighters, when they get in a competitive fight, they kind of have that point where they start to drop off. I mean, everybody gonna drop off. Like, you're human, but it's like a notable drop off where it's like you're not nearly the fighter you were when this fight started. Where some people, they know how to take their breaks here and there, or they just in such good shape that they train to fight. Like, they train to be high paced. They train to be in your face when from the start of the first bell to the last bell of the fight. They train to be in your face. And Namajunas is just one of the people where I feel like she significantly drops off as the fight goes on, especially if the fight's tough. And I don't think she could take the best shot. I don't think she's the most durable fighter. I mean, she's not a pushover or whatnot, but I definitely think Weili Zhang's tougher than her. Definitely think Weili Zhang hits harder than her. I think he pushed harder. I think he's stronger than her. And like, I feel like Namajunas can have good success early. It looks slick, look clean. But even like, look at the last Andrade fight. She was looking real good, real slick early. Really, that's both fights. But the first fight, she got slammed in her head and knocked out. But it was like she was looking bad. She was just doing poor defense she just was not letting her submission go. That was bad. You know, bad decision making. The second fight, she was looking good early. Not as good as she was looking early in the first fight. But looking good, looking clean, looking like the more technical striker, looking slick, looking long, and looking good, looking great. But then this fight started to go on. Andrade started to find the uppercut up the middle and was catching her with that, even though she like a midget, and she had a good significant height advantage over Andrade. Andrade was able to find the uppercut. So like, she falls into patterns. So even if a short fighter, I'm not saying like Andrade's a bad fighter, she's a great fighter, but you should not be getting caught by an uppercut at that distance and keep getting caught by a shorter fighter like that if you're that probably that good of a striker. But it is what it is. But either way, with this one, I feel, well, basically what I was going with that one is that in that fight, even though she won, if that fight would have been a 5-round fight, Andrade would have beat her again. That's all I'm saying. But she was lucky that it was a 3-round fight and she was able to get by off her first 2 rounds, because the fight was not going her way towards that bell decision. She was getting tagged up, she was getting bust, she was getting rocked, she was getting concussed. Was she getting dropped or anything? But you could definitely see she was wearing those shots much more than she would want to, or even a coach would want to. And it was looking very good for her opponent, but it was just happened to be a 3-round fight, and it played out for her. So in this one, it's gonna be a 5-round fight. She going against somebody, MMA Mav, who destroyed Jessica Andrade. Don't hit as hard, not as aggressive as Andrade, but overall more technical than Andrade. And gonna be in your face, gonna be aggressive, gonna push that pace, and gonna be able to push that for 5 rounds. You're going to get hit in this one, and she hits harder than you. I just feel like it's gonna be a case of where, Namajunas is gonna look good early, or semi-good early, but as the fight goes on, Weili Zhang, the pressure and pace and her power is really gonna wear on Namajunas. And then like, she's gonna get breaking down, and she's not gonna have no real room to exit. She don't really have great wrestling. She's never been a strong fighter. So she could try to, go for a desperado takedown. She could try to do a jump in submission. But like I said, Zhang is not no one-dimensional fighter. She's solid everywhere, so she's gonna see whether she any type of submission or any little desperate move that Naoma Yunus wants to take grappling-wise and really be able to neutralize and probably just stay in her guard and land ground and pound on her, and even try to dominate her there. Cause by the point she start really initiating any of that, it's gonna be too late, or really needing to or forcing it, she's gonna be too late. But either way, I think it's a case where she'll get broken down, and then the fight goes on. She's gonna get broken down by the pressure and the power and the pace, and stop, I think, early on in that fourth round. So in this one, I got Weili Zhang via fourth round TKO.